Hey everyone, want to learn a cool design trick? Today, we're making the trendy glass morphism effect in Affinity Photo. Let's get started. First things first, fire up Affinity Photo and open your chosen image. Once it's open, make sure to duplicate the original photo by pressing Ctrl plus J. This duplicate will be our starting point, so let's rename it to Copy 1 to keep things organized. Now, with our duplicated layer selected, head over to the Layer Effects tab by clicking on FX at the bottom of the Layers panel. Here, apply a Gaussian blur effect and increase the blur radius to around 15 pixels. If you notice any edges getting wonky, make sure to tick the Preserve Alpha box under the slider. After that, let's add a color overlay. Set the color to white and adjust the opacity to around 12% to keep it subtle. Once you're satisfied, close out of the Layer Effects tab. Moving on, we're going to create two rectangles. These will serve as our containers for the glass morphism effect. Position and resize them according to your image's composition. Now, duplicate the Copy 1 layer and rename it to Copy 2. Don't forget to rename the rectangles as well to keep track of everything. Here comes the crucial part for achieving the glass morphism effect. Drag the Copy 1 layer and drop it above the right rect layer. Be careful not to drop it on the thumbnail of the right rect layer, as it will create a mask, which we don't need here. Repeat the process for the Copy 2 layer with the left rect layer. To clean things up, remove the stroke and fill from the rectangles to get rid of any white borders. You can also change layer effects of these images later by clicking on FX on the layers. Now, let's address a little problem. When we try to manipulate the rectangles, the images move along with them. To fix this, simply drag the image sublayer out of the rectangle layer, make your adjustments, and then carefully drop the image back above the rectangle. To add some depth, let's introduce some noise to our rectangles. Adjust the opacity as needed to achieve the desired effect. Now, let's kick things up a notch by applying different filters to the images. Start by removing the Gaussian blur and replacing it with a depth of field blur from the live filters. Everything outside of the outer circle will be blurred, and everything inside the inner circle will not be blurred. The area between the inner circle to outer circle is like a blur gradient. The blur gradually increases from the inner circle to outer circle. You can move this circle using central node and scale. Rotate using other nodes on the circles. Experiment with it to get a nice blur. Repeat the process for the second image, adjusting as necessary. And there you have it. You've just crafted a stunning glass morphism effect. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more design tutorials. If you have any questions about glass morphism or Affinity Photo, leave a comment below and I'll be happy to help. Thanks for joining me today, and I'll see you in the next one.